Hey, this is Ben.
This is Kevin.
So we're doing the next tournament here. There was only six people, so we only have three matches. And what you just saw is that's actually me on the right-hand side. And I'm playing Agent Callus on my Whisper and a Decimator. And I just gave one of his ships Agent Callus. And we're using the cloaking token you see on the left-hand side to represent the ship that has Agent Callus. New this tournament, we're having R2-D2 represent who has initiative, and I've got initiative. I've got Captain Crunch, or Captain Auken, who if he runs into you, you do 1 point of damage, and I have Kylo Ren, Palpatine, and Expertise on it. So Kylo Ren will do, I'll show you the dark side, which allows me to choose a pilot damage card and put it on the card, and then if I hit him with a critical, then that damage card takes effect and it goes through shields. Then I'm doing Whisper with the Agent Callus, which Agent Callus allows me to flip a focus to either a hit or a swerve or an evade for that one ship. So I'm hating on that one ship.
Yeah, you are.
I'm hating. advanced cloaking device. Veteran's Instinct and Fire Control Systems, which allows me to target lock somebody. Advanced Cloaking Device just says is when I perform an attack, I can perform a free cloak action, which I can only do if I'm not stressed. And I think I actually made a mistake on this one, and I think I cloaked when I was stressed on this one. I'm not sure, but we'll see if I cheated or not as this goes along.
Okay.
So what is we're playing, Pat?
One note about Ben's squad.
Callus? Oh, check this out. I'm cloaking. I modded my ship, and it has a magnet on it, and the LED lights up. I'm very proud of that. I did some it's my first soldering attempt, and there's a read switch and an LED light. Contact me at benstuckey@hotmail.com if you'd like me to do a mod on your ship base, because I think it's kind of fun. So, and actually, my decimator... if I get a stress and I put the stress token in the right place, it turns red. But I didn't get a stress this time on Auken. Anyway, go ahead. So what's Pat doing? Why is Pat spread out so much? That's the only thing I thought he should have been clustered since he's got three.
That's a great question because it doesn't make a lot of sense with the loadout. But I'm going to start. So Cavill on the bottom of the screen is carrying unhinged astromech. Makes all your green... All your three maneuvers green, which really helps a Y-Wing to have green maneuvers. He's using ion torpedoes.
It costs five, and you do one ion token within range one.
One ion token to the ship you shoot at.
And then it's gone, right?
And then... And then you do one ion to every other ship at range one of it.
But
it's one, so a large base ship it won't do anything against.
I think that with the new rules, if you get one ion token with a large base ship, it stays there. It does not go away, right?
Yeah, the ion tokens don't clear until you do a one straight maneuver.
Okay.
So you have to get the second ion token. The problem is he has no other way to give ions in the list.
Yeah, okay. Well, we need to talk to that boy.
Yeah, right. Auto blaster turrets, which would be great if he can pull it off against Whisper, because you cannot cancel normal hit results. You can cancel crits before hits, but you can't cancel. So all those four.
I think he might have tried to hit me with that. With Whisper, we'll see what's coming up. But of course, took an evade, so I can't cancel with a die roll, but I can cancel with a token, right?
I have to look up the rules on that. The other thing is Cavill, if you're outside of his firing arc, gets an extra dice. Auto blasters is only two dice. Cavill ups it to three.
I think he forgot about that. I'm not sure.
Oh. Okay, and then we got our other favorite little annoying scum pilot that just wrecks havoc. Finn Ra, that gets an extra dice at range one.
And an extra dice, defense
dice. Defense
at range
and
three.
Attack dice. Yeah. At range one. No.
At range three, right?
You're thinking of Talonbane.
Oh, Talonbane. Okay.
Finra gets an extra defense and extra attack dice at range one.
Oh, okay.
Fearless gives him an extra attack or an extra hit result if he's in your arc and you're in his arc at range one.
Oh, okay.
He also has auto blaster turrets or auto thrusters. Auto thruster says if someone shoots you outside of their arc, aka they shoot you with a turret, they get to change a blank defense dice into an evade or beyond range two.
Oh, I just showed him the dark side.
Well, that's a problem.
Well, I don't know which one he's trying to find it now. So hopefully, I think we had him show the tick, show the cards this round. Yep. For this round, we're trying to get everybody to do that. So here we go. We're going to move it. That apparently I was showing you the dark side right there. who knew that the dark side was actually a card in X-Wing?
Right.
You know, I was describing this game to a few friends today. Today's Easter, by the way. Happy Easter. We left friends' house early so we'd come in and record this commentary, and they're like, well, what's this game you're playing? And I'm telling about it and telling about the movement dials, that each ship has a specific movement dials. And they said, oh, like chess. And that's the second person that said that it's like chess. And it's true. It's kind of crazy. You have to guess people's movements. I think that's kind of the thing. I don't know. I think I gave him pilot skill zero on there.
You gave him blinded. No, you gave him blinded pilot.
Did I give him blinded pilot? I didn't see it come across.
Which is the one that stops him from shooting.
So what I'm trying to say is if people ask you, they don't know X-Wing, what's X-Wing? Just tell them it's chess with spaceships.
Yes.
It's much more than that, but that's apparently what at least two people I know think it is.
For non-gamers, that's probably...
It's true. These two people were non-gamers. One of the guys, he plays pool a lot. He's a pool junkie.
Yeah, for people that are not into tabletop gaming, I think that's a good description. There's a lot more to it than that, but... Finra also has the coordinate dump, the title card, that gives him a defense result if he's in arc at range one. Or... He's in arc, and he's in the defender's arc, or attacker's arc. So he's got to be face-to-face with somebody else to get an extra defense. Talonbane Cobra was the one that Ben was talking about earlier.
So I took an evade here. Go ahead. Talonbane Cobra. We didn't even finish it. Sorry, guys.
Talonbane Cobra has Predator that gives him a reroll.
Uh-huh.
And he has homing missiles, which... is a bloody expensive missile. But think it...
But Pat loves missiles.
He does. He's playing the wrong
ship. He loves missiles and bombs like crazy. But I think homing missiles...
I want to be right about it. I want to look this up.
I can't remember either because I don't play with many people who play missiles. But why is he flying away? I mean, we need
Where
to talk to him.
Where is he flying away?
He flew away. I mean, none of his ships are engaging me. I mean, I think he thinks he's gonna get behind me, but it's a decimator. It's a 360, so I don't know what Pat's doing. But that's why we play. We play to learn.
So, homing missiles is four attack dice, range 2 to 3. Defender cannot spend evade tokens during the attack.
But I can evade them with dice.
Yes.
So, but how expensive? It's 5. Oh my goodness.
I don't know.
I would put expertise on some of these. It always surprises me that Cavil has 5 hull and 3 shields. An 8 for a small ship like that, that's pretty beefy.
I mean,
that's not normal for a small base ship, is it?
Yeah, no. But you've also got a... Typically, the dial on a freaking... Y-Wing is atrocious.
Oh, is it? Okay.
Yeah, it's horrible.
I play Rebel and Imperial. I actually don't own any scum ships, so I'm not familiar with them.
Well, it's a Rebel ship.
Is it a Rebel ship?
It was originally a Rebel ship.
Oh, okay. Well, so I don't know scum that well. Scum kind of breaks the rules, but they also have these really big positive things balanced by these really big negative things. So if they can pull it off, awesome. But if they can't pull it off, oh, Jesus.
They're a faction of shenanigans.
It is the shenanigans.
By the way, I wanted to mention Talonbane Cobra like Finn Rock and roll five dice at range one.
Ooh.
He gets to double his range bonuses.
Yeah. Well, Whisper at range one that I'm playing rolls five dice.
Yeah, well, that's because she starts out with four.
Well, yeah. I'm just saying.
She rolls four at range three as well.
Well, yeah.
Unlike Talonbane or Cavil.
Because she's a pretty girl. No, she has yellow eyes.
She is a pretty girl. You know she's a senator. She was a senator, right?
Oh, I know.
No. I'm thinking of Countess Riad.
No, Countess Riad, yes. Countess Riad's pretty cool, too. It kind of moves like Whisper. Oh, I'm doing something. Oh, I'm Palpatining. Okay, so new rules of Palpatine. You have to do it beforehand. So what I'm doing a lot with Palpatine is if I've got target lock on somebody, and I've got a even if I've got an eyeball, I'm still rolling it in case I get a crit with it, because then I can do a crit on something else. So I'm re-rolling it to hope to get the double crit.
Okay.
That's what I'm trying to do, because if I can do double crit on somebody, that's pretty powerful, especially if
So you're actually playing more risky because of the change to Palpatine.
Well, yes, I have to. Yeah, yeah. Because otherwise you can save Palp for the defense. Now you cannot save Palp for the defense, which I guess seems kind of perfect for Palpatine, right? I mean, that seems kind of in character.
Yeah. But Palpatine and Kylo Ren, they're so good together because Palp is going to make you push crits through.
A couple of these times, though, I didn't use Kylo Ren that often, because I would rather have the target lock with the Decimator, because with Expertise, I get to re-roll, and I have a high chance of hit, crit, or eyeball. I'm doing it for all of them. So that's why a lot of times using my action for Kylo Ren seems almost secondary to getting target lock on somebody. You see what I'm saying? I'm playing the numbers.
I got a question for you.
Yeah.
Did what I think just happen?
What?
No. So you shot Talonbane Cobra Whiz and got... Do you put the...
Talonbane Cobra, show the dark side, and I hit Talonbane Cobra, and it went past his shields, yeah.
At range three?
I don't know. Let's see. Maybe Danielle did the wrong one. I don't think so, though. Yeah, I think she's got it on the wrong one. Danielle was our camera woman. Oh, look at the back of my head. Oh, good. I'm not going bald. Perfect. Look, I don't have male pattern balding yet. Perfect. Look at that. I missed the goddamn asteroid.
I can't believe I did that. You went over it, but you got past it.
I went over it. I don't mind that, though. Oh, look at the stress. You can barely see the red. Oh, that was debris. Sorry.
Okay. Because you're running debris with this list, aren't you?
Oh, yeah, I always run debris because I fly like crap, and so I want at least half of them. I can still shoot when I run over them, right?
Well, of course. And then, you're already penalizing yourself by taking only two ships. So you really don't want to lose any attacks.
Yeah.
So that makes sense to want to go debris.
Well, and what I usually do, I've said this before, is I put, when I'm playing this, I put debris on the far side of the field, because that's where I try to jump forward. Most of my battles, on a couple of these, this game it wasn't, but most of my battles are on the opponent's side of the field, and if most of the debris is there, then it's better for me. I always put the asteroids closer to me, because you're going to do a four forward to begin with almost every time. And I jet past the asteroids
this
to begin
is
with, and it's not a problem.
A really ironic set. Look at the asteroid placement. That the middle of the board is fairly open.
It is. I placed that, and I placed that one. Look, I see. I flipped, and I got a stress, and I think I'm gonna cloak after this because I forgot. And you shouldn't flip. You shouldn't do a K turn with Whisper. You shouldn't, because then she's open. And she's going to take it all.
Well,
that sounded kind of nasty, but I'm still... What is he doing over there? He's flying around in the middle of nowhere. What are you doing, Pat? Engage, engage, engage. I don't understand his strategy. We're going to have to talk to him in person and see what he thought about this. I actually kind of hoped he would commentate with us today, but so we could tell his side of the story.
Yeah, that would have been awesome.
We're trash talking right now. I just didn't understand why he engaged. He could have beat me up a little bit more if he just engaged. That's all he had to do.
I don't think he had a good way to negotiate between those asteroids, though.
Yeah, but he flew away. He's been flying away.
Yeah, I don't know why you wouldn't bring Fenra in early on to hit hard. Because the way he's got Fenra set up, he just wants to get that thing in tight.
Yeah. Bless you. Bless you so the demons don't enter your body.
And try to get those range one shots off. Yeah, those damn demons.
But, all right, let's. I don't know what's happening here. Oh, target locking. Yeah, Whisper is everybody's favorite target lock buddy.
I think that's kind of a mistake. I don't know.
Well, it depends. He's hoping I'm going to fly it bad. Because I can.
I mean, right now, it's probably the right answer because Whisper's at it open.
Yeah.
You're only going to get two defense dice. Whisper's. Okay.
Range two. I'm firing on. Shouldn't
be able to cloak.
I'm firing on who?
Cavil.
Cavil. Ooh, I palped it. No. I did Agent Callus and flipped it from an eyeball.
It was Whisper.
So yeah, so two hits. I think. We'll see if it happens. It did. Two shields went. I tried to be really clear because it's really hard to tell with these dice. So I'm trying to pull it away and show the ones that. That are there. Alright, so mine, I'm going to shoot on Cavil. Why did I shoot on Talamane Cobra? I don't understand. I think she might have done the wrong one, but that's just me.
Because Talamane Cobra wasn't running away from the fight.
Ugh.
He figured he got some time to do work on Fenra when he comes in later.
Because I hit, we forgot this several times. Since this is a kind of a casual tournament, I'm doing I got focus, and see, look, I've got stress and I evaded. So I cheated right there. Right there, I cheated. Right there. You got to remind me of that.
It does say perform an action, doesn't it?
Perform an action. And you can't perform actions if you have stress, which...
Correct.
It's something that's like an intended side effect in the rules, but it's not really called out. And so I'm stupid. But it still looks good lit up.
And actually they've
so I've got an evade and he's going to shoot me here because he's got target lock, but I'm at range three. I get five freaking defense dice plus I have a
well, you should have only been getting three.
Yeah, but
so if you were playing correctly, this was the right play, but since you
let's see what he rolls. Maybe he rolls horribly and it won't matter in the end, but if he rolls really well and I get a bunch of eyeballs, he's going to... Oh, he only got one hit. And
well, he only had two hits.
One hit.
No, I think he had two.
Two hits.
Two.
All right, so he should have taken my shields away. And I got two evades. Three evades.
Yeah, so, I mean...
I turned an eyeball. Oh, so I got three evades. Oh, two evades.
Yep.
Oh, so I cheated.
Yeah, so...
Well, I don't know. No. If I... Yeah, no, I had...
You
I
wouldn't
had four
have had the
dice.
Cloak.
Yeah, I wouldn't have had
you
the cloak.
You would only have three dice.
Two dice.
And you still got the one for range three.
Yeah. Oh, three dice.
So you would have three. Yeah.
Okay, I cheated. Sorry, Pat. Remind me next time. I know now. Knowing's half the battle.
Oh God!
So this we're commentating this just after the Last Jedi trailer came out, and we're all wondering about those sand ships with the red sand. What the hell's going on? I mean, it almost looks like a pod racer. It's crazy, crazy. I can't wait to see them, and I hope it's actually a spaceship and they produce it for this game. But it may just be land based like the AT-ATs. So,
well, they also can't. They did at one point. Or they do
the
have...
The red sand was crazy, though.
Right.
Sorry, go ahead.
They did come out with the the striker, which is mostly an in-atmosphere fighter.
Oh, yeah. Well, all the shuttles are technically a lot of in-atmosphere. But still, if it's...
Right.
You're not going to see an AT-AT or a Walker in X-Wing. So I don't know if this is a strictly...
strictly
terrestrial based ship, and if so, why is that thing digging in the dirt? What the hell's up with that, and how can that be a good thing? I mean, what if you hit a boulder? Bam! Face plant, just like you're snowboarding or something.
I'm finagling
my decloak, and I forgot the decloak, and he was graciously allowing me to decloak. You know what I found with Whisper? And I found it out because the whole reason I'm playing this is I fly horribly. And Whisper forces you to fly really well. You have to learn to fly. What I found out is the one hard turn with Whisper with a barrel roll gives you crazy maneuverability and doesn't like put you out there in the open. You can do crazy stuff with that.
Yep. One hard was...
Look, I don't have any male pattern balding again. I just have the one little one little spot where my unicorn horn must go. Oh! I don't know what that is. Maybe it's a devil horn.
Oh.
Or something for ring toss. Okay, so see, he's put himself out so far. I'm just... Yes, Cavill has 8 hull, but... I am hitting him hardcore here.
Where is Cavill go? That's where Cavill stopped?
Yeah, he went one forward or something like that. I don't know, but
who was he?
Here he goes. Oh, he's doing a 3 hard. So he gets out of my range, I think.
He gets out of that's actually really good.
Yeah, that's a good flying. Good flying. Good flying.
Because if he remembers to use his he should be in range 1.
He's in range 1.
That should allow him to use his auto thrusters or auto blasters.
I think turret. He does kill my Whisper during this.
That'll allow him to use auto blaster turrets on Whisper, which...
Oh, I haven't done my movement yet.
Ooh.
Now I'm at range 2.
And if you barrel roll, you can get out of range.
No, I'm stressed. I can't. I shouldn't be able to.
2 banks, not a green maneuver?
Oh, it is a green maneuver. That's why I pulled it. But, I don't know. I think I took a target lock. I did take a target lock for some reason. I don't know why.
Yeah.
Oh, I haven't done my action. Now I'm doing it. And I'm barrel rolling. I'm trying to barrel roll. And I can. Am I hitting him?
Well, you should...
I don't know why I barrel rolled, but there we go.
My honest opinion is you should have barrel rolled the other way.
I couldn't. So, what am I doing? Am I taking an evade? I think I'm taking an evade. Yeah, I'm taking an evade.
Beat a barrel roll down and forward to stretch out.
See, I think I put myself out of this. I'm still learning to fly this. And actually, with Whisper, I'm finding that any maneuver, once I get into range of somebody, beyond range 1 is a bad decision. I think the range 1 barrel roll just allows you so much maneuverability... One hard with a barrel roll allows you so much maneuverability. I don't know how much I would use on that unless I'm trying to flee.
And you're going to be able to get your target locks from your fire control system.
Yeah.
So it's not like you really care about target locks. And Whisper also can pick up
where I got the target lock. I hit him last time.
Whisper can pick up a focus by shooting at someone as well.
Yep. So he's bringing his ships back in. He's doing maneuvers and boosts like crazy.
He's trying. But
he's trying. And but, this is turn 5, and the other 2 ships have fired only once, right?
Yep. Whisper and Oinkins are not are hard to kill. They are tough ships.
All right, he's target locking and re-rolling 2. He's got 1 hit.
You've got to put damage on a decimator to kill it. You can't be losing shots to it.
2 hits on my decimator, I think. Oh, I'm at range one, so I think I rolled.
You mean range three?
Oh, range three, sorry. So no, no, he did one hit. I did roll on evade, so he did one hit.
But you get what I'm saying. I mean, he does not want to be losing shots. And,
oh, I'm in range one, so he can't use the...
Well, he can. It only... auto.
I'm reading it. So I'm like, no, you can't do that.
Auto blast it.
I'm reading it again. Now I want a double sure.
Only works at range one.
Okay. But I think I can use my... I can't do dice, but I can do...
If he rolls crits,
uh-huh.
You can use your dice and your evade token. Where... it's only normal hits automatically get through.
Oh, he got... Well, no. I don't think I can use dice. Two... All right, so I get to roll my two defense dice. Oh, I don't get to roll dice, but I do have the evade. I don't know what I did here, to tell you the truth.
Yeah, I don't... He should have rolled three
dice. He's showing me.
He's showing you you don't get to use dice on it.
Right, but I get to use the evade token, which I just pulled, so I should only do one shield. Yep, there it goes.
I don't get so to we use got dice. Cheating on both sides of the table. No.
Not cheating. He didn't... I don't... I mean, he's in control of his cards. I can't read his cards every time.
Well, he's missing things.
He's missing things and I'm cheating. What a great game.
The way the evade token's supposed to work... is according to the rules, you add an evade result to your dice when you spend the token.
Oh, so I can't. But see, it specifically says cancel it with dice. That is really sketchy.
Does it say?
Yeah.
All right, I'm gonna pull up the auto thruster. Is
or well, auto blaster? Auto blaster. Okay, I'm palping. I palped a crit, so I've got a crit and two hits. He only had. That's the bad thing with Cavill. Yeah, he's got eight, but only has one defense. I think I just beat him up a little bit.
You beat him up.
I did beat him up. Oh, look, he got something.
No, you're right. It does say defense dice. So, yeah, I think you're right.
So I was good. I didn't cheat a second time.
You're right. He cheated himself by forgetting to add a dice for Cavill's
pilot. Well, he showed me Cavill's pilot. He showed me his card, right? He held it up and showed it to me.
I think he showed you the Autoblast.
No, he showed me the card.
The actual pilot?
The actual pilot card. Folks, go back and look at it, but I think he showed me the pilot card. Back up, like, 20 seconds.
Huh. Did he just only roll two hits?
What's he doing? Oh, he's using something.
You're right. It does say dice, so... I'll give you that. He's using talent. What?
Oh, he's. I think he's using.
Oh, he rearranged the cards.
Oh,
you're
that's right.
Correct.
Yeah, he rearranged the cards because the way Danielle has them listed is she wanted it top to bottom: Cavill, Fenrir, and Talonbane Cobra. So it's easier for her to do the damage.
Because you're correct. She did make a mistake earlier.
Yeah, she did. So she upped Talonbane Cobra and knocked down Cavill, which I've gotten down to one because he disengaged the first half of the battle.
Well, Cavill was the only one in the fight.
Right, that's what I'm saying. He wasn't engaged with
the other two
ships.
And that's just, I mean, you can disengage, but you don't want to have one ship hanging out there getting shot at while your other two ships are trying to fly around. Unless you have a super tough ship that can take it, like Sindar failed.
Well, I had one of these other matches I was playing against, what's his name, with the custom painted ships and the space tug. Toot, toot. What's?
Steve.
Steve. And his what's the one that's the space tug with the quad jumper? I was within one shot of killing him. And if I would have done that, I would have taken a lead. And so he disengaged and ran away so I couldn't kill it.
Yep.
Which is a smart thing to do because we only had 15 minutes left. And he knew that if he were able to fly away with that one, that I would not be able to win. I wouldn't have the points lead on that one.
Yep. And it is Space Dog.
Space Dog. Doot, doot. I hope... Did he ever get to play main table this time? Because His ships are amazing.
Well, yeah, he just painted that space tub because he's been playing that in all of his tournaments lately.
Yeah, I was trying. So what happened here is because of Oiken, I turned and bumped him, and blew him up. Oinkin' for the kill. Oinkin' for the kill.
That is such a good way to waste an action.
Oinkin' for the kill. Exactly. I wasted an action, but oink, oink.
You got a kill out of it. I
Captain okay. Crunch.
I will definitely take that.
Bam. God. Just when you least expect it. Oinkin' up your butt. Oh, see, so I should have cloaked. I don't know why I didn't cloak, but I took an evade action. That was stupid.
Well, an evade's guaranteed. Two dice.
That's not good. That's a bad thing. I'm learning to play the setup. This was actually the first setup I played, and I lost horribly with it because Whisper's really hard to fly. At least it is for me. Maybe for you folks out there in YouTube land, it isn't a bad thing, but... it's not good.
Nothing. Are you kidding?
Oh no, he's barrel rolling over. He's getting in range one. Why would he be one in range one of that one? Sorry, what were you looking at?
So technically the statistics on taking an evade versus taking a cloak. The Vade's actually better.
Oh, okay. Well, then
now, if you had a focus,
I idiot proofed it. Yeah, if I had a focus. Yeah.
Well, basically, the statistics boils down to you get 1.75 evade results on average with an evade token with four dice, which is what it gives you. It gets you to 1.5 average.
Oh. I have got to download that app. I haven't looked at that. That might be helpful to do builds. What's the name of that app?
The little statistic thing I've been doing?
Yeah.
Just XW Dice Statistics.
Oh, okay. So X-Wing Dice Statistics. XW Dice Statistics. Oh, that's cool. I'll have to look that up. All right. So he did really horrible. He had five dice and he had one hit on Oinkin. Five dice. He was rolling bad. He actually twice he had five die rolls, and he only did a few damage to me.
This is why I like Finra with Push to Limits. Is either I can make it happen because I use repositions.
Yeah,
and then I'll have focus target lock with a range one shot.
Well, then he needs to take off the damn ion thing and push the limits on a couple of these dudes.
Fearless does not do enough work, in my opinion.
Yeah.
Unless you need that 2 points for, it's going to make a lot of money somewhere else.
Yeah,
I can't see why you'd run Fearless on a. Now, I have to give Pat some credit because Pat's a very new player to X-Wing.
Yeah, this is his second tournament. He's only been playing for about a month,
and he's playing with stuff he owns.
Oh yeah.
And he does not... I don't think he has a push to limit in his library.
Oh, that's true. He's playing within what he actually owns. Well, that makes sense why he chose these things, then.
Now, the build that you'll see most often in tournaments on Finra is Atani Mind Link, Auto Thrusters, and Coordinate Dawn Protector.
Yeah. So you pass the...
Well, it allows him to get double
focus. Pass the focus around, yeah.
So someone else will take a focus action. That'll give Finra and... usually your entire squad of three ships has that.
That's
so
focus.
Your lowest pilot guy takes the focus. Everybody gets focus.
It's action economy. That's what. Okay.
Then when Finra gets his turn, he'll take an additional focus token. Because he can still take the action because he's not considered taking it the first time.
Yeah.
So he gets two focus tokens, which... tends to be really well because he keeps one for defense. I like focus target lock for an attack.
All right, so I'm deciding. All right, let's see.
But
I can't remember. I think I tried to bump him here.
I also like playing a little bit more art dodgy Finra. Thin Frost, like a soon tier fail that just hurts worse.
Yeah. As you notice, I'm not using Kylo Ren that much. It depends upon who I'm playing against. It seems like it means something or not.
Yeah, but with a 3-point card, I don't think that's a problem. It gives you answers in so many situations.
Yeah, that's
Like
true.
if you've got a dodgy ace, you can make them pilot skill one.
Bam, I hit him. Or zero, pilot skill zero. And I've used that. That's what I've used more than blinded pilot, is I've used pilot skill zero, because it takes him out of the mix.
Pilot skill zero,
And it.
or the one that does damage when they hit stuff,
Yeah.
especially if you're gonna run blo if you're gonna block, which you could do in this list by using Oinkins as a blocker.
Yeah, well, I'm. Yeah.
Because most people are gonna be higher than PS4.
Yeah. All right, I got him within range one here, because I boinked him. Let's see where he goes. I think he what he chose does not put him beyond my base.
Yeah, if you'd have put that crit card on there, he would have hit you, and then he would have took another point of damage for hitting you.
Yeah.
He'd have took it. You'd have put damage on him when you hit him, and when he hit you,
Yeah, he would have take well, yeah, if he
he'd have
hit me,
taken an
if he
additional.
hit me. But I don't know. I think between that and
It also makes people play more conservatively when they have that card on them.
yeah, he didn't go beyond me. He's not moving.
So that means Finn's not going to get shot, which really hurts.
Yeah, and he's at range one of Whisper.
You're taking ha right now. You just took. I don't think he has any shots because.
Well, he hasn't moved this guy yet.
Okay,
So
so
he'll get a shot.
Talonbane.
Talonbane will have a shot
Yeah,
if you
but
get
you
it
took
right.
half his damage out of the fight for this turn by
Yeah.
bumping, and you got a damage
I
hit.
think he forgot that I can bump, even though I just killed one of his pilots by bumping. So if you know I'm gonna bump, go with a three, because you gotta get beyond my base, otherwise you're messed up. Even if you don't have a shot beyond my base, at least you're well, no. I would have had a shot on him, right, if he got beyond my base at
Would
range
you have
one.
a maneuver that could have got a block on him at range three?
No. Well, yeah, no, I wouldn't have thought it that way, because I move first because of my pilot skills lower, so I'm definitely wanting to do the boink.
Okay,
Then,
yeah, because of Oinkin.
yeah, Oinkin Boinkin,
Yeah,
Captain Crunch.
might as well.
So many nicknames.
Might as well
I
guarantee
just,
the damage, and then if he does move to clear you. Holy Jesus, that's a roll
yeah,
and a
I
half.
got five hits because I decided to palp the hit on that one, I
Did you
think.
palp one in?
I need to put the palp token down when next time I play, so we see. I've got to bring it with me.
Ooh.
He's done.
Oh, Talonbane just got eliminated by Whisper.
Whisper, yeah.
Whisper went.
Now we forgot. He graciously allows me to go back and do all my Whisper post attack actions. If this was a strict tournament, I would have just been screwed because I get cloaking, I get focus, I get target lock, I get a McDonald's gift card, and
Yes, you do. It's only good for 50 cents, so you gotta get two of them to get a soda.
Yeah,
But
I guess we're old. We're back in the day when you get the coupon book in your stocking of 50-cent tear-off ones. Now,
dear
now it's just a plastic card when you get a gift card. You don't get the actual coupon book
God.
or the gift certificate book.
Yeah, right.
Bam. So, Decimator, yeah, there she goes. All right, Danielle caught up.
Yeah, the problem with the Talonbane Cobra is its action bar, really.
Yeah, I mean, I don't. What is the draw of this? I mean,
He gets the
he gets three and two, and is his pilot still nine? But he has no shields, and his actions suck. What's the reason for playing Talonbane Cobra? Well, I mean, other than he's only plays the ships he's bought, and I think he has four ships, but.
Honestly, Talonbane Cobra, and I think the best way to play him is to try
Oh,
to
he does have one shield. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
is try to stay back at range three
Oh.
and then shoot from range because you're going to get four defense dice
Yeah.
and you're going to get three attack dice, and that beats most ships in the
So
game.
what is he playing with it? Oh, the homing missiles
He has
and
Predator.
Predator, so he can re-roll.
I would put Lone Wolf on it and run it at range three.
Oh, yeah. Instead of homing missiles.
Try to poke.
But he doesn't
Well, instead
have
of
that.
Predator.
Instead of Predator?
I think he does have one
Well,
wolf.
I don't know. Predator and Lone Wolf is a pretty powerful combination.
Yeah, can, but they're both mods. EPTs.
Elite pilots.
Oh, like dear God. You could do it on A-Wing.
That would be evil, wouldn't it? A-Wing. Predator and Lone Wolf?
Yeah, A-Wing test pilot allows you to...
Oh, my goodness.
...run two EPTs. Now, what? you know what's evil?
That is evil.
Is Lone Wolf any expertise?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. So I'm making him follow me.
And do they get an evade action? That would be an annoying...
See, I forgot to cloak. Oh, I'm going to show him the dark side, I believe.
I show you the dark side.
All right. Let's see if I show him which dark side I'm doing. I think it may be... I don't know what it is. I can't remember. Oh, Jesus. Look at that. Did you see how...
You bumped the crap out of that ship. This is you're right. This is some amateur hour.
This is amateur hour. Yeah, cheating, misremembering things, flying horribly. Jesus, who the hell is playing? Oh, it's me. Okay, great.
It's a good move for Whisper. What is?
I don't know why I didn't cloak. I'm taking an evade. I don't know why I didn't cloak.
Because you want a shot.
No, but I should have had a cloak from last shot. I forgot to take all my actions, and I didn't remember till the end.
You
and
forgot
so
to...
I didn't do it. My post-attack actions.
Oh, crap.
Oh, no.
Look where you are.
I'm range one and out of his arc, and I get five dice, and he's going to go kaboom, kaboom, I think.
This is the problem with Talonbane.
See, I'm range one of both of them. Ugh.
This is one of those places where... Most like a Protector Starfighter roll, a barrel roll, and get yourself in a good position.
Right now, I palped. Oh, I hit him with five, and I palped a crit, and he only gets two dice, and he's gone. I think.
Did he blink, or did he get
two, three, four?
Oh.
Oh, I hit twice. I hit with five hits. I didn't win the lottery that day. This is a Saturday, so no lottery for me. Because apparently I'm rolling good on X-Wing.